श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम।
श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 3 द स्टेटस क्यो चैप्टर 13 द अपीयरेंस ऑफ लॉर्ड बराहा। श्रीशुक उवाच निशम्य वाचं वदतो मुने पुण्यतमां नृप भूय पप्रच्च कौरव्यो वासुदेव कथातृतः।
श्री शुकदेव गोस्वामी सेड, ओ किंग, After hearing all these most virtuous topics from the sage Maitreya, Vidura inquired further on the topics of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, which he adored to hear.
Vidura uvacha savai svayam bhuva samrat प्रियपुत्र स्वयंभुवः प्रतिलभ्य प्रियां पत्नीं किं चकार ततो मुने।
विदुरा सेड, ओ ग्रेट सेज, व्हाट डिड स्वयंभुवा द डियर सन ऑफ ब्रह्मा डू आफ्टर ऑब्टेनिंग हिज वेरी लविंग वाइफ।
चरितं तस्य राजर्षेर् आदिराजस्य सत्तम ब्रूहि मे श्रद्दानाय विश्वक्सेनाश्रयो ह्यसौ।
ओ बेस्ट ऑफ द वर्चुअस, द ओरिजिनल किंग ऑफ किंग्स मनु वॉज अ ग्रेट डिवोटी ऑफ द पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड हरि। And thus it is worth hearing of his sublime character and activities. Please describe them. I am very eager to hear.
Shrutasya pumsam suchirashramasya nanpanjasa suribiridi tortaha tattat guna nushravanam mukundha पादारविन्दं हृदयेषु येषाम्।
Persons who hear from a spiritual master with great labor and for a long time must hear from the mouths of pure devotees about the character and activities of pure devotees. Pure devotees always think within their hearts of the lotus feet of the personality of Godhead, who awards his devotees liberation.
Shri Shuka uvacha iti bruvanam viduram vinitam sahasra shirshnascharanopadanam prahrushta roma bhagavat katayam प्रणीयमानो मुनिरप्यचष्टं।
श्री शुकदेव गोस्वामी सेड, द पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड श्री कृष्णा वॉज प्लीज्ड टू प्लेस हिज लोटस फीट ऑन द लैप ऑफ विदुरा बिकॉज विदुरा वॉज वेरी मीक एंड जेंटल। The sage Maitreya was very pleased with Vidura's words, and being influenced by his spirit, he attempted to speak.
Maitreya uvacha yada svabharyaya sartam jatasvayam bhuvo manuh pranjali pranatascedam वेदकर्पम अभाषत।
द सेज मैत्रेया सेड टू विदुरा, After his appearance, Manu, the father of mankind, along with his wife, thus addressed the reservoir of Vedic wisdom, Brahma, with obeisances and folded hands.
Tvam yeka sarva bhutanam janma krut vrutti dappita tatapi na prajanam te शुश्रूषा के नवापवेत।
यू आर द फादर ऑफ ऑल लिविंग एंटिटीज एंड द सोर्स ऑफ देयर सब्सिस्टेंस बिकॉज दे आर ऑल बॉर्न ऑफ यू। प्लीज ऑर्डर अस हाउ वी मे बी एबल टू रेंडर सर्विस अनटू यू।
तत्विदेहि नमस्तुभ्यं कर्मस्मीत्यात्म शक्तिरु यत् कृत्वेह यशो विश्वग अमुत्र च भवेत् गतिः।
ओ वर्शिपफुल वन, प्लीज गिव अस योर डायरेक्शन फॉर द एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ ड्यूटी विद इन अवर वर्किंग कैपेसिटी सो दैट वी कैन फॉलो इट फॉर फेम इन दिस लाइफ एंड प्रोग्रेस इन द नेक्स्ट।
ब्रह्मोवाच प्रीतस्तुभ्यम् अहम् तात स्वस्तिस्तात्वाम् क्षितीश्वर यन्निर्व्यलीकेन हृदा शादिमेत्यात्मनार्पितम्।
लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा सेड, माय डियर सन, ओ लॉर्ड ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, आई एम वेरी प्लीज्ड विथ यू and I desire all blessings for both you and your wife. You have without reservation surrendered yourself unto me with your heart for my instructions.
Yetavadhyatmajairvira kharyahyapachitirgurau shaktyapramattairgruhyeta सादरं गतमत्सरैः।
ओ हीरो, योर एग्जाम्पल इज क्वाइट बीफिटिंग अ सन इन रिलेशनशिप विद हिज फादर। दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ अडोरेशन फॉर द सुपीरियर इज रिक्वायर्ड। वन हु इज बियॉन्ड द लिमिट ऑफ एनवी एंड हु इज सेन एक्सेप्ट्स द ऑर्डर ऑफ हिज फादर विद ग्रेट डिलाइट and executes it to his full capacity.
Sattvam asyam apatyani sadrushan yatmano gunaih utpadya shasa dharmena gam yajnai purusham yaja.
Since you are my very obedient son, I ask you to beget children qualified like yourself in the womb of your wife. Rule the world in pursuance of the principles of devotional service unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and thus worship the Lord by performances of yajna.
Param shushrushanam mahyam syat praja rakshayan rupa भगवांस्ते प्रजा भर्तुर् ऋषिकेशो नु तुष्यति।
ओ किंग, इफ यू कैन गिव प्रॉपर प्रोटेक्शन टू द लिविंग बीइंग्स इन द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड दैट विल बी द बेस्ट सर्विस फॉर मी। व्हेन द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड सीज यू टू बी अ गुड प्रोटेक्टर ऑफ द कंडीशन सोल्स सर्टनली द मास्टर ऑफ द सेंसेस will be very pleased with you.
Yesham natushto bhagavan yajnalingo janardana tesham shramohyabartaya yadatmana drutasvayam.
The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Janardana, Lord Krishna, is the form to accept all the results of sacrifice. If he is not satisfied, then one's labor for advancement is futile. He is the ultimate self, and therefore, one who does not satisfy him certainly neglects his own interests.
Manur uvacha adesheham bhagavato varteyami vasudana sthanam vihanujani prajanam mama cha prabho.
Shri Manu said, O all-powerful Lord, O killer of all sins, I shall abide by your order. Now please let me know my place and that of the living entities born of me.
Yadhoka sarva bhutanam mahi magna mahambasi asya uddharane yatno devadevya vidiyatam.
O master of the demigods, please attempt to lift the earth which is merged in the great water, because it is the dwelling place for all the living entities. It can be done by your endeavor and by the mercy of the Lord.
Maitreya uvacha parameshtitvapam madye tatasannam avekshyakam katam yenam samunneshya iti tadyauti yachiram.
Shri Maitreya said, thus seeing the earth merged in the water, Brahma gave his attention for a long time to how it could be lifted.
Srujato me kshitir varbihi plavyamana rasam gata atatra kim anushteyam asmabhis sarga yojitaihi yasyaham hrudayat asam sayiro vidadhatu me.
Brahma thought, while I have been engaged in the process of creation, the earth has been inundated by a deluge and has gone down into the depths of the ocean. What can we do who are engaged in this matter of creation? It is best to let the Almighty Lord direct us.
Ityabidyayato nasa vibarat sahasanaga varahato ko niragad angushta parimanakah.
O sinless Vidura, all of a sudden, while Brahma was engaged in thinking, a small form of a boar came out of his nostril. The measurement of the creature was not more than the upper portion of a thumb.
Tasya vipashyata kastaha kshanena kila bharata gajamatra prabhavrude tadatputam abhun mahat.
O descendant of Bharata, while Brahma was observing him, that boar became situated in the sky in a wonderful manifestation as gigantic as a great elephant.
Marichi pramukhair vipraihi kumarair manunasah drushtva tat saukaram rupam tharkayam asa chitrada.
Struck with wonder at observing the wonderful boar-like form in the sky, Brahma, with great brahmanas like Marichi, as well as the Kumaras and Manu, began to argue in various ways.
Kime tat sukara vyajam satvam divyam avastitam अहो बताश्चर्यम् इदम् नासायामे विनिस्रुतम्।
Is this some extraordinary entity come into the pretense of a boar? It is very wonderful that he has come from my nose.
Drushtan gushtashiro matraha kshanat gandashila samaha apisvit bhagavan yesha yajnyo me kedayan manaha।
First of all, this boar was seen no bigger than the tip of a thumb, and within a moment he was as large as a stone. My mind is perturbed. Is he the supreme personality of Godhead Vishnu?
Iti mimam satastasya brahmanasahasunubihi bhagavan yajna purusho jagarjagendra sannibaha।
While Brahma was deliberating with his sons, the supreme personality of Godhead Vishnu roared tumultuously like a great mountain।
Brahmanam harshayam asa haristamsha vijottaman swagharjithena kakubaha pratisvanayata vibuhu।
The omnipotent supreme personality of Godhead enlivened Brahma and the other highly elevated brahmanas by again roaring with his uncommon voice, which echoed in all directions।
Nishamyate gharghritam svakedha kshayishnu mayamaya sukarasya janastapasatya nivasinasthe tribipavitrair munayo grunansma।
When the great sages and thinkers who are residents of Janaloka, Tapoloka and Satyaloka heard the tumultuous voice of Lord Boar, which was the all auspicious sound of the all merciful Lord, they chanted auspicious chants from the three Vedas।
Dhesham satam veda vidhanamurthir brahma vadaryatma gunanuvadam vinadya bhuyo vibhudho dayaya gajendra lila jalama viveja।
Playing like an elephant, he entered into the water after roaring again in reply to the Vedic prayers by the great devotees। The Lord is the object of the Vedic prayers, and thus he understood that the devotees' prayers were meant for him।
Utkshipta balakachara kathoraha shata vidunvankara romashatvake kurahata prasita dhamshra iksha jyotirbabase bhagavan mahidraha।
Before entering the water to rescue the earth, Lord Boar flew in the sky, slashing his tail, his hard hairs quivering. His very glance was luminous, and he scattered the clouds in the sky with his hooves and his glittering white tusks।
Granena prutya padavim vijigran kroda padesha svayamatvarangaha karala damshrapya karala drukpyam udvikshya vipran grunato vishatkam।
He was personally the supreme Lord Vishnu and was therefore transcendental, yet because he had the body of a hog, he searched after the earth by smell। His tusks were fearful, and he glanced over the devotee brahmanas engaged in offering prayers. Thus he entered the water.
Savajra khutanga nipata megha vishirna kukshistanayan udanvan utsrushta dhir gormi bujair ivarthash chukrosha yajneshvara pahi meti.
Diving into the water like a giant mountain, Lord Bor divided the middle of the ocean. The two high waves appeared as the arms of the ocean, which cried loudly as if praying to the Lord. O Lord of all sacrifices, please do not cut me in two. Kindly give me protection.
Khurai kshura prair dharayam stadabha Utparaparam triparurasayam Tadarshagam tatra sushupsuragre Yam jivadanim svayamapyadatta.
Lord Bor penetrated the water with his hooves, which were like sharp arrows, and found the limits of the ocean, although it was unlimited. He saw the earth, the resting place for all living beings, lying as it was in the beginning of creation, and he personally lifted it.
Svadhamstrayodrutya mahim nimagnam sahuttitasam ruruche rasayaha tatrapi daityam gadaya patantham sunaba sandipita tivramanyuh.
Lord Bor very easily took the earth on his tusks and got it out of the water. Thus he appeared very splendid. Then his anger glowing like the Sudarshana wheel, he immediately killed the demon Hiranyaksha, although he tried to fight with the Lord.
Jagana rundana masahya vikramam salila yebam rugarad ibambasi tadrakta pankan kita ghanda tundho yata gajendra jagatim vibhindan.
Thereupon Lord Bor killed the demon within the water, just as a lion kills an elephant. The cheeks and tongue of the Lord became smeared with the blood of the demon, just as an elephant becomes reddish from digging in the purple earth.
Tamala neelam sita dhanta kotya shmam utkshipantam gajalila yanga prajnaya baddan jalayonu vakhair virinchi mukya upatasturisham.
Then the Lord, playing like an elephant, suspended the earth on the edge of his curved white tusks. He assumed a bluish complexion like that of a tamala tree, and thus the sages headed by Brahma could understand him to be the supreme personality of Godhead and offered respectful obeisances unto the Lord.
Rushaya uchuhu jitam jitam te jita yajna bhavana trayim tanum svam paridhunvate namaha yadroma ghartesu nililyurattayas tasmai namakkarana sukarayate.
All the sages uttered with great respect, O unconquerable enjoyer of all sacrifices, all glories and all victories unto you. You are moving in your form of the personified Vedas, and in the hair holes of your body the oceans are submerged. For certain reasons, to uplift the earth, यू हैव नाउ अस्यूम्ड द फॉर्म ऑफ अ बोर।
रूपं तपै तन्ननु दुष्कृतात्मनाम् धुर्दर्शनं देव यदत्परात्मकम् छन्दांसि यस्य त्वचि बर्हिरोमस् वाद्यं दृषित्वं गृषु चातुर्होत्रम्।
ओ लॉर्ड, योर फॉर्म इज वर्शिपेबल बाय परफॉर्मेंसेस ऑफ सैक्रिफाइस, बट सोल्स हु आर सिंपली मिस्क्रियंट्स आर अनेबल टू सी इट। ऑल द वेदिक हिम्स, गायत्री एंड अदर्स are in the touch of your skin. In your bodily hairs is the kusha grass, in your eyes is the clarified butter, and in your four legs are the four kinds of fruitive activities.
Sraktunda asit sruva ishanasayor idodare cha masa kharna randre प्राश्रित्रम् आस्ये ग्रसने ग्रहास्तुथे यच्चर्वणं ते भगवन् अग्निहोत्रम्।
ओ लॉर्ड, योर टंग इज अ प्लेट ऑफ सैक्रिफाइस, योर नॉस्ट्रल इज अनदर प्लेट ऑफ सैक्रिफाइस, इन योर बेली इज द ईटिंग प्लेट ऑफ सैक्रिफाइस, and another plate of sacrifice is the holes of your ears. In your mouth is the Brahma plate of sacrifice. Your throat is the plate of sacrifice known as Soma. And whatever you chew is known as Agnihotra.
Dikshanu janmo pasada shirodaram त्वं प्रायणीयो दयनीय दंष्ट्रः जिह्वा प्रवर्त्यस्तव शीर्षकं क्रतोः सत्यावसत्यं चितयो सबोहिते।
Moreover, O Lord, the repetition of your appearance is the desire for all kinds of initiation. Your neck is the place for three desires, and your tusks are the result of initiation and the end of all desires. Your tongue is the prior activities of initiation. Your head is the fire without sacrifice as well as the fire of worship, and your living forces are the aggregate of all desires.
सोमस्तु रेतः सवनान्यवस्थितिः समस्ता विभेदास्तव देवदातवः सत्राणि सर्वाणि शरीरसन्धे त्वं सर्वयज्ञक्रतुरिष्टिभन्दनः।
ओ लॉर्ड, योर सीमन इज द सैक्रिफाइस कॉल्ड सोम यज्ञ, योर ग्रोथ is the ritualistic performances of the morning. Your skin and touch sensations are the seven elements of the Agnishtoma sacrifice. Your bodily joints are symbols of various other sacrifices performed in 12 days. Therefore, you are the object of all sacrifices called Soma and Asoma, and you are bound by yajñas only.
Namo namaste kila mantra devatha dravyaya sarvakratave kriyatmane vairagya bhaktyatma jayanu bhavitha jnanaya vidya gurave namo namaha.
O Lord, you are the supreme personality of Godhead and are worshipable by universal prayers, Vedic hymns and sacrificial ingredients. We offer our obeisances unto you. You can be realized by the pure mind freed from all visible and invisible material contamination. We offer our respectful obeisances to you as the supreme spiritual master of knowledge in devotional service.
Dhamstragrakotya bhagavamstva yadrutha virajate bhudara bhusa bhudara yatavanan nissaradho datadrutha matangajendrasya sapatra padmini.
O lifter of the earth with its mountains, which you have lifted with your tusks, is situated as beautifully as a lotus flower with leaves sustained by an infuriated elephant just coming out of the water.
Trayimayam rupamitam cha saukaram bhumandalena tadatadrutena te chakasti shungoda ghanena bhuyasa kulachalindrasya yataiva vibramaha.
O Lord, as the peaks of great mountains become beautiful when decorated with clouds, your transcendental body has become beautiful because of your lifting the earth on the edge of your tusks.
Samstapayainam jagatam satastusham lokaya patnim asimataram pita videma chasyai namasasahatvaya yasyam svatejognim ibaranavadah.
O Lord, for the residential purposes of all inhabitants, both moving and non-moving, this earth is your wife, and you are the supreme father. We offer our respectful obeisances unto you, along with Mother Earth, in whom you have invested your own potency. Just as an expert sacrificer puts fire in the arani wood.
Kashradda ditanyatamastava prabho rasam gataya buva udvibarhanam na vismayo saudvayi vishva vismaye yo maya yedam sasrujeti vismayam.
Who else but you, the supreme personality of Godhead, could deliver the earth from within the water? It is not very wonderful for you, however, because you acted most wonderfully in the creation of the universe. By your energy, you have created this wonderful cosmic manifestation.
Vidunvata vedamayam nijam vapur janastapas satya nivasino vayam satashikodduta shivambu bindubhir vimrujyamana brushamisha pavitaha.
O Supreme Lord, undoubtedly we are inhabitants of the most pious planets, the Jana, Tapas and Satya Lokas, but still we have been purified by the drops of water sprinkled from your shoulder hairs by the shaking of your body.
Savai bata prashta matista vaishadhe yah karmanam paramapara karmana yad yoga maya guna yoga mohitam vishvam samastam bhagavan videhisham.
O Lord, there is no limit to your wonderful activities. Anyone who desires to know the limit of your activities is certainly nonsensical. Everyone in this world is conditioned by the powerful mystic potencies. Please bestow your causeless mercy upon these conditioned souls.
Maitreya uvacha ityupasthiyamanosau munibir brahmavadibhi salile svakurakranta upatattavitavanim.
the sage Maitreya said, "The Lord, being thus worshipped by all the great sages and transcendentalists, touched the earth with his hooves and placed it on the water."
Sa ittam Bhagavan Urvim Vishvaksena Prajapatihi Rasaya Leelayon Nitam Apsunyasya Yayauharihi.
In this manner, the personality of Godhead, Lord Vishnu, the maintainer of all living entities, raised the earth from within the water, and having placed it afloat on the water, he returned to his own abode.
Yayevametam harimedaso harehe katam subhadram kataniyamayinaha shrunvita bhaktya shravayeta bhoshathim janardanosya shuhruti prasidati.
If one hears and describes in a devotional service attitude this auspicious narration of Lord Bhor, which is worthy of description, the Lord, who is within the heart of everyone, is very pleased.
Tasmin prasanne sakalashisham prabhau khim durlabam tabiralam lavatmabihi ananya drushtya bhajatam guhashayaha svayam vidatte svagatim paraparam.
Nothing remains unachieved when the Supreme Personality of Godhead is pleased with someone. By transcendental achievement, one understands everything else to be insignificant. One who engages in transcendental loving service is elevated to the highest perfectional stage by the Lord Himself, who is seated in everyone's heart.
Khona maloke purushartha saravet purakatanam bhagavat katasudam apiya gharnanjali bhirbhavapaham aho virajyeta vinanaretaram.
Who, other than one who is not a human being, can exist in this world and not be interested in the ultimate goal of life? Who can refuse the nectar of narrations about the personality of Godhead's activities, which by itself can deliver one from all material pangs?
Hari Om Tat Sat.